Would you like to learn about the process for designing a cloud architecture or enterprise architecture? If so, this video is for you. This video is another part in our series about the cloud architecture and enterprise architecture process. In this video, we will continue the discussion about the process for developing a technology architecture. Specifically, we will introduce Phase E of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. Phase E is about finding opportunities to deliver the architecture that was designed in the architecture vision, the business architecture, the data architecture, and of course the technology architecture. At GoCloud Careers, we are a member of the Open Group and leverage the TOGAF framework as it provides a structured and repeatable approach to designing cloud and enterprise architectures that drive digital transformation. We like the TOGAF framework as it's an industry standard, which is used by all major players in the enterprise architecture space like IBM, Microsoft, Dell, Intel, VMware, Accenture, PricewaterhouseCoopers, Deloitte, Cognizant, Capgemini, and all other key organizations. After developing the technology architecture, the next phase of the enterprise architecture process really begins with thinking about how the architecture can be implemented. Now, the cloud architect or enterprise architect will not be implementing the architecture. That's for another team, but we do need to plan how the architecture will actually be implemented. If you haven't seen the other videos on developing the architecture vision, developing the business architecture, developing the data architecture, or developing the technology architecture, you can find them in the description of this video. Now we'll be discussing Phase E of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework, which is all about planning the implementation. This phase begins with examining any business constraints. It's about making sure the organization has the financial resources for the new architecture. It's about making sure the organization has the people necessary for the implementation. Ideally, this phase also includes an enterprise architecture maturity assessment to determine the organization's capabilities. Next, we need to do a gap analysis conducted in the previous phases as well. Remember, we examine the architecture vision, as we will need to go from the current state to the future state. We also examine the business architecture, and we need to go from the current business architecture to the future business architecture. We also examine the data architecture and the technology architectures, because we need to go from the current state to the future state, supporting all of the business goals and needs. Now we need to examine interoperability requirements. In order to achieve a successful deployment, we need to minimize interoperability conflicts. Now to do this, there are really two options to minimize interoperability problems. Option one is to use highly interoperable systems. For example, in cloud computing, this means not using proprietary applications like an Amazon DynamoDB, and instead using more open standards such as a MongoDB or an Apache Cassandra, which will work in all clouds, all data centers, and everywhere in the world. Option two is to create an integration plan, a plan to take systems which are not interoperable by nature and make them interoperable. Note, when you do this, it's going to substantially increase cost, complexity, and increase the likelihood of problems later. But there are times where you have no choice and we must use a proprietary system. For example, there may be a special application that's critical to the business, but not interoperable with other systems. But whenever possible, try to avoid using proprietary systems unless there's a good reason to do so, as it will ultimately cause interoperability challenges and create unnecessary complexity. And as a rule, the more complex the system, the higher its cost, and the more things that can break. Next, we need to formulate the implementation and migration strategy. We have choices based upon the new architecture. In some cases, it's going to be a greenfield deployment, meaning it's a brand new implementation. This is going to be the simplest. It's a matter of rolling out the new systems. Other times, it's going to be revolutionary, meaning a major change. This is going to take very careful planning to keep the systems up and running while we make the changes. This will take significant planning and a very highly coordinated implementation. Sometimes the architecture is evolutionary, meaning it's about technical incremental improvements, and this of course will need a phased approach. If the architecture needs to be rolled out in phases, it's going to be necessary to develop transition architectures for each phase along the way. The last phase of the TOGAF architecture development method is creating the architecture roadmap and transition plans. If the architecture needs to be implemented in phases, then transition architectures for each phase must be designed. For example, phase 1, we upgrade the network. In phase 2, we add GPU servers. In phase 3, we add our AI applications after the infrastructure is ready. Regardless of the approach, we must determine the timelines for the architecture deployment. Along with timelines, we must set up clear work packages and critical success factors for the team that will ultimately implement the architecture. We then need to store the documents and all work products in the architecture repository. Remember, the architecture repository is where our critical documents are stored. Now you know Phase E of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework, also referred to as Opportunities of Solutions. Of course, this is a high-level overview. If you'd like to have a deeper understanding of this, make sure to look at our training content. The link is in the description below. To learn how to get your first cloud architect job, please download the free ebook and join us for the free webinar on how to become the ultimate cloud architect. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified for future videos and events that we can do to help you in your cloud architect career or your enterprise architect career. I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.